So one can vary the rules of the chaos game a little bit and come up with some additional interesting shapes and have a little bit of fun. So here I am back at the program that we used before. And let's start just going back to what we did previously. So 10,000 points with some small dots. So there's some things that we can change down below. So one is we can change the movement ratios. So right now this says red point 0.5. That means you move halfway to the red point. This 0.5 means you move halfway to the green point, halfway to the blue point. So I think that if they're set a little bit differently, one gets some fun shapes. So let's try this. Suppose you move 54% to the red, green, and blue points instead of 50%. So then things shrink up a little bit, and we have a Sierpinski triangle of sorts that has kind of broken apart into smaller Sierpinski or triangles that aren't, it's not fully connected anymore. We could do something else. We could go over here and maybe change this into 0.47. And then we get some overlap. It's not quite as clean a Sierpinski triangle as before. The triangles overlap themselves a little bit. Let's get a few more points. So the shape is a little bit different. Let's go back to 10,000. Maybe we can exaggerate this a little more. Let's go to 0.44, see what that looks like. Yeah, so at some point it starts to look sort of like a fractal plaid pattern to me. I'm not sure. We can make this colorful if we click on color code. That then is just going to make the top ones red, the left ones blue, the right ones green. That could be a fun thing to play around with. So let's go back to 0.5. Let me show you one more thing. Okay. So we could also change the relative probabilities. So in the game that the version of the game that we played, you were equally likely to go in the red direction, what I called A, in this direction, or in this direction. We could change that up. So maybe I'll make red now three times as likely. And hit enter so that change goes into effect. And the tops of the triangles now are heavier because the tops correspond to those A moves. And so now we see a Sierpinski triangle. The shape is the same, it's just not uniformly filled out anymore. It spends the dots spend more time in some parts of the triangle than others. And this is a little bit interesting to me. It kind of gives it a 3D effect or a kind of faded effect or something. Let's try it with 10,000 points. It's a little less dramatic then. So there's lots you can play around with here. You can change the movement ratios. You could make them different. I was keeping them all the same. You can change the relative probabilities as well. And then one last really fun thing you can do is you can change the number of points. There's no reason why we have to have 3 points. We could have 4 or 5 or 6 or 7, and then we would just with equal probability move halfway or whatever way to each point and iterate that. Let me show you just one more thing here. So you can also move these points around. So let's say I want to move the red point. Then I would click this on move, and then wherever I hit my mouse, that's where the red point's going to go. So that can give you, if you want to sort of change the shape of the triangle, here I'll move the blue point. You can do that as well. So there's lots that you can experiment with, and I'll suggest a few explorations that you can do for the homework for this week.